Hello. So today I'm going to be talking about active recall. Now that might sound like a Hollywood movie where there's lots of shooting and explosions. It's not. It's about how you can test yourself to help yourself learn. And what you do is you find the gaps in what you think you believe. Now there's a very real danger, especially if you watch too many YouTube videos, you'll think you understand something. But in actual fact, when you sit in front of a keyboard and you try and actually code from scratch without actually referring to your notes, a book, some snippets of code, GitHub, Stack Overflow, you actually find out you don't understand, or not that you don't understand it, but you don't understand everything. You don't understand your code, your language, whether it's Python, C, whatever. You don't understand it enough. So what I've found is this article. So we'll get to active recall in a minute, and I'll give you some examples of how I'm going about doing it. This is called the Feynman technique by a very famous person called Richard Feynman, and you have not taught until they have learned. The year is 1962. The place is California Institute of Technology. There's a lecture on physics in progress at the front of the hall. Scratching away on a huge blackboard is Nobel laureate Richard Feynman. I'll let you read that in your own time. It's on BrainScape Academy. Search for Feynman technique. I'm just going to pick out, don't worry, this is not going to be just me scrolling through a web page. I'm just going to quickly pick out some of the key parts of this that I've read and that I think maybe, if you've not come across before, then they may be useful. What you do is you solidify your intimate understanding of a subject, and that's basically explaining something as if you were explaining it to a 6-year-old. If you can't explain it to a 6-year-old, you don't understand it yourself. So, do I understand the Feynman technique? That's like recursion, isn't it? I think I do. So, I'll show you in a minute how I'm going about actually using this practically. We now notice that the technique of simplifying material for teaching. It's so useful for learning because it invokes a mental process known as metacognition, or thinking about your thinking. A bit like, was it Descartes said, I think, therefore I am? Was it? I don't know. Don't quote me on that. This act of reflection, is critical to how BrainScape, this company, itself helps you improve your knowledge retention. So, there's another quote by Socrates. Yeah, so many good quotes. Anyway, we're not here for quotes. What we're here to look at is how we can actually practice this. Using the Feynman technique is for studying means you'll build the kind of solid understanding that won't dissolve in a cloud of caffeine-fueled stress on exam day. Now, whether you're doing exams or for exam, you could substitute a job interview where you get put in front of a laptop and you get asked to write some code. And say you don't have any internet access, or they've switched off internet access. So, yeah, you need to be able to write something from scratch. Here's how you can practice the Feynman technique as part of your exam study habits. Let's scroll down, set the stage, take a walk. So, yeah, remove yourself from kind of your learning where you're at your desk or your laptop, go away, and then walk for half an hour and then actually try and recall what it is you actually learn. So, yeah, good tip. Become your very own annoying first grader. Keep asking why. Why does it work that way? Why? Gravity makes objects fall to the ground. Why? Anyway, tell a story, encourage curiosity, go forth and actually teach. So if you think you understand it, try explaining it to somebody else. And if you get stuck explaining it, then it probably means you need to go back and revisit and refine. Revise and refine even. Once you're back in front of a computer or a smartphone, yeah, revisit and then obviously just brush up on the bits that you don't know. So rinse, repeat. So there we go. And what is active recall? Active recall is more effective than either recognition or passive review at consolidating information in your long-term memory. So yeah, long-term memory. Your long-term memory is a bit like if you compare the stack and the heap. You want the data on the heap. You want it there to persist. If you know anything about load balancers, or yeah, so persist is a good word. Using active recall, in other words, trying to remember information from scratch, helps you learn that information and permanently remember it. So, right, practical example now. This does not relate to Python, so sorry about that, but it relates to learning code. So VS Code, I'm actually trying to teach myself how to write traits, implementations and structs, and how to combine all three. So the first thing I do is actually try and just get the syntax correct for essentially line 6, line 10, line 16, 22 and 26. So all that is actually the, effectively it's the definitions, isn't it? So get those right. And with VS Code, you can, you've got these little arrows where you can expand or collapse things. So to start off with, when I'm trying to learn something like this, where you've got five things all linking together, I just write out these five when I'm reciting this. So if you're trying to recite something, then start with kind of the basic framework, and then you can fill it in afterwards. So what I've realized is that I can actually successfully create structs, implementations, eventually, with just a tiny bit of referral, I realized that I think I had that missing on the trait function. So I've highlighted line 7. And sorry about that. I'll just close all these again because they're distracting. What I actually did in the end was got all of these five things correct. And then I realized that the implementation was incorrect. So you do need to actually test everything from start to finish. And that is all part of the active recall. So just because you've remembered one example, you might remember kind of an Alice and Bob example from, say, for instance, a no starch book on Python Crash Course or something. You might remember that example. So you might be able to recite that example, but then when you come to do a different one, so when it's not Alice and Bob and it's actually Tom and Jerry, then it all falls apart. So not only do you need to test your recall on one example that you've committed to memory, you actually need to then implement it with different names, different function names, variable names, and so on. So yeah, active recall and the Feynman technique. That's all I'm going to talk about today. And if you are learning, whatever you're learning, whether it's Python, C, JavaScript, so on, you can do that. You can apply this to anything. So try and type it from scratch. And the reason why I won't be doing this as a live video is because my typing skills are not fast enough, and it would make for quite a frustrating video to watch. So thank you for watching, and I'll be back with something very soon.